Hey guys, I just picked up a copy of Killzone Shadowfall for $8. So while I know the game's been out a while, it's new for me. So here's a quick review.
The war between the Vectans and the Hellghast ended in seconds. They call it the Terracide. A billion lives lost in the Petricite fires that swept Helgen's surface, reducing it to nothing more than a lifeless rock. In the days that followed, an uneasy truce was negotiated and a settlement was reached. The survivors were to be given refuge on another world. Vecta, home of those responsible for Helgen's destruction. Half of the planet was given over to the survivors, and the Vectans that lived there were forced to leave. This was no longer their home. This was New Helgen.
So the backstory is pretty much what you just saw. That's the opening. We're following Lucas Kellen from the time he's a young boy, which is right there in the window watching what's taking place.
Listen, I know this is tough, but we don't have a choice. We have to get to the wall. We'll be safe on the other side.
Lucas tries to escape with his dad when he's very young, get on the other side of the wall, and unfortunately things don't go according to plan.
Let's go. We're gonna be okay, Lucas. I promise. This isn't forever. We'll be back. This is Vecta. This is our home. And it always will be. I want you to remember that.
So after watching his dad get brutally murdered, Sinclair of the Shadow Marshal program comes to his rescue and ends up raising him into the Shadow Marshal program, where he is then inducted. And that's where we come in, going through multiple missions of trying to take down the bad guys. But then again, who are the bad guys? Now, I've only gone 3 chapters in so far. I'm already hooked, though. The graphics, as you can see just by the opening scene here, are off the hook. They took complete control of the 1080 and made it work. Really, really in depth. You have a sense that you're actually in a city and you're in all these other areas. Incredible detail. So it's very similar to the Call of Duties in that you have multiple missions to go on from one to the next. You're never really sure who's on your side and who's not, and that's only 3 chapters in, mind you. And I'll tell you this much right now, if all I could do is replay these 3 chapters over and over again, I still got my $8 worth, so I'm not complaining. What you're about to find out is some of the cool things that separate this from a lot of the other shooter games that I've seen and played. If you watch this channel, you know that I'm a big Last of Us fan. That's still the all-time best game in my opinion. It'll always be the game that I keep going back to over and over again. But when I think of that and several other games like Call of Duty, how often you get in a scenario where you're being flanked and you don't have teammates there to help you. In this game, it's a little bit different because they give you somebody who is always there to help you, and that is your Owl Drone, who we're about to meet here in just a couple of moments. Your Owl Drone basically is, imagine a pit bull with a machine gun. He is there to protect you and to do your bidding, and he's able to do several different things to help you accomplish that. Before we get to the Owl Drone, let's go with the basics. You have this echo hearing ability that'll show you enemies in and around the area so that you can plot the best way to take them out. I love doing the melee thing, so this is right up my alley. Variety of melee attacks. Then, you get to meet your Owl Drone. There he is! So with this guy, you can give him 4 different commands. You can have him do what he just did, which is lay down cover fire, and he'll take a bunch of the bastards out for you. Then he can also help you with a rappel, he can give you a shield, or he can stun your opponents. And there's one other thing he does on command, and that is he can heal you if you're not dead, and you have a attack. So now let's put this thing to the test. Let's get into some action. Oh yeah, I forgot, he can hack computers too. Got a bunch of different skins if you want to decorate them up. You can make them look however you want. I actually did buy the blood spatter one to make them look badass. So let's see what it looks like in real life action. All right, there's a guy right there on the landing. I'm going to rappel down and drop on him. Boom! That's what I'm talking about. And again, my owl is the one allowing me to do the rappelling. I point, he sends, I go down. Now, in this case, we got three guys there. I'm outnumbered. I send my owl in, draws their focus. And then I take him out. The other cool thing is while these guys are busy with my owl, I come in and I can just go and shiv them. While he's being detained, I throw my grenades. They're still busy with my drone. I come and flank them. Bam. Hey, buddy. All day long, man. So you will never be outgunned in the sense that you'll always have somebody backing you up. Now, if you're like me and you like the big cinematics, damn, this thing delivers cinematics. Yeah, they've got some cinematography scenes in here that are absolutely amazing that could easily be on the big screen. The way they use the lighting and the color is just really amazing stuff. And I don't know that I've seen anything even more recently better than this. So it might be hard to find out who the good guys are from the bad guys sometimes, but as long as you have a weapon at your side, you should be in pretty good shape. Hopefully this review helped you out. I hope you like it. And if you did, don't forget to take that little box down the corner that says like and click it. In the meantime, enjoy. Hopefully, again, if you haven't already got this game, go out and get a used copy now.